With an outstanding lineup of 20 comedians spread out over 4 days. Along with great performances inside, there will also be outside entertainment, making the festival a must-see event. We'll be covering the entire event, bringing you interviews, entertainment, and so much more.
This was my first comedy special. I am so happy. I got my first special. Showtime. It's gonna be a blast. You guys tune in, holla, catch me. I'm gonna be the next one. So I just had an absolutely fantastic time, except for a little bit of heat in that audience. I mean, the theater was burning. I was so hot, I had the theater hot, put it like that.
It feels super awesome being on this all-female show. I mean, I just really appreciate Snoop Dogg giving us this opportunity. It's showtime.
Showtime.
I felt that the crowd tonight was mixed, meaning it was mixed in origin. We had from the elderly to the fresh out of junior high school looking people. We even had Bay Bay's kids, the star Bay Bay's kids, she was here. We had some veterans up in here, you know what I'm saying? We had all the geriatrics. It was really hot, it was hot. And then half of Mexico was here too, so that was really cool too.
I actually enjoy all female shows. I've done a lot of them because I do a lot of military tours, so they put us together with like all chicks. It'll be like boobs over Baghdad, and they just corral a bunch of ladies. Which is totally fun because that's the only time you ever get like female bonding. And I feel like a lot of women aren't supportive of one another. So this is an opportunity to kind of embrace Lady Town.
Stevie Wonder fans in the house. Put your hands if you like Stevie. Say yeah! Baby, superstition. writing's on the wall. Baby superstitious, light is about to fall. Then it must be baby, broke the looking glass. 7 years bad luck, the feeling in your back. When you believe in things that you don't understand, then you survive. Superstition ain't the way. Yeah. Are you feeling the love? Ooh, baby, superstition. Wash your face and hands. Let me know the problem. You all that you can. Keep me. You don't want to save me. I'm standing in my song. When you believe in things that you don't understand, they suffer. Superstition ain't the way, no, no, no. Na, na, na. You know what I'm talking about. Lily, I've been praying for the future, hoping better times will come. And though the answers are right before my eyes, some things are better left undone. It's all a mystery where I'm from and where I'm going. Just enough faith to carry on. And judging by the weather, I guess I'm never the day I'm dead and gone. Won't you take me down to the river's edge? Traveling, find my peace of mind. Just me and that old highway, as we leave the rest behind. It's the first trail of the sunlight. Oh, it shines across the land. Makes me thank all of creation. Time is still at hand.
Man, I started doing stand-up comedy when I was 8 years old at the Stephen F. Austin Elementary talent show. And well, you know what happened was I saw my family one night all together, uncles, aunts, all together when I was like 6 years old. And they were all laughing at the TV. And I was like, what the hell are they laughing at? And I looked over and they were watching Richard Pryor. And from then on, I was like, that's it. That's what I want to do. Not the drugs, but that's what the stand-up, that's what I want to do. So ever since then, man, I knew what I wanted to be. Jeez, the crowd was amazing. Look, man, bottom line, there's two places. The number one place I would like to do my special is back home in Texas. You can't blame me for that. But if I had another choice, it would be right here in the Inland Empire. And I say that because people here in the Inland Empire are real people. You know, they're not full of it. They wake up, they go to work, they do their job, they pop open a beer after work, and they come to the show, they wanna laugh, they wanna have a good time, and it's just one of those places. I'm a blue collar guy. It's a blue collar place. And me and the blue collar people, we get along. You know, performing in Hollywood, not so much. But out here in the IE, I love my people out here in the IE. When I'm rich, IE, and when I'm famous, I ain't moving to Beverly Hills, baby. I'm gonna buy a big old chunk of desert, and I'm gonna live out here with you guys. I'm gonna play horseshoes, and we're gonna barbecue, all right? And we're gonna buy a dirt bike, and I'm gonna put Got Dirt on my truck. That's what I'm doing. I might end up in Funtucky. You don't know. I might end up in Rancho Cucamonga. You don't know. It ain't gonna be Beverly Hills, baby. See you soon.
What did you think of tonight's performance?
It was awesome. Very great show. Steve Trevino's funny, funny guy.
What do you think of the lineup?
I like the lineup. I was here last night for the ladies and Snoop Dogg. It was a good lineup.
What did you think of tonight's show?
Oh, I thought it was awesome. I thought Steve was so hilarious. I could relate to a lot of his little stories that he had, so it was even funnier.
I was gonna be a cop when I was a youngster. And on the way back, I was partying. I was gonna go to the academy, actually. I had an academy date. And on the way back, partying from some club, I got DUI, man. So I said, hey, I gotta do something. So it was a comedy. Let me tell you something about Jay Leno. I love sharing this information about him. He's, you know, first of all, the troops. The fact that you're out there with the troops, that's just an awesome, you know. I mean, you couldn't ask for a better audience. You know, people are sacrificing their lives, you know, for America. I mean, that being said, let me say about Jay, man, is that he is one of the nicest guys in the world. Whenever he does something nice for someone, he'll ask that person, do me a favor, don't tell anybody I did this. And he means it.
Dr. Bombay and the Blue Machine! How y'all doing out there? Somebody make some noise out there, please. Hand claps, come on. Come on. Put them up. Come on, y'all. Somebody make some noise, please. So good seeing everybody out there. Ain't nothing but love in the house. Come on! Somebody scream! Lord have mercy.
Many of you, my dear. And brother, 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 I don't punish me, sister, or with brutality, brother, and talk to
What's going on, girl?
Stand-up comedy, it's more just, you're just saying what you want to say. When you do TV comedy, you have to sort of tailor it. You mean like not swearing? It's more like a corporate show where you just have to edit yourself a little bit, but I don't really care. Like I could do an hour of G material. I do a lot of corporate shows. Can we get more walkie-talkies going off in the middle of my, that's why we lost Vietnam. People yelling into walkie-talkies in the jungle. Yeah, there's nobody here but us. Come on. Oh, God, it ain't come. Look out, Norton. The Viet Cong are here. The crowd was great. They seemed a bit warm. It was about 114 today outside and about a 118 inside. When I walked out on stage, they had already taken the program and made it into a fan, and they were fanning themselves like they were at a Baptist church. I always was a mimic and I could get a laugh at it. When I was 8 years old, I saw the movie Stripes in the theater because my parents couldn't get a babysitter and they didn't know there was nudity. And then I came home and I did the entire movie like for my friends. And I discovered I could imitate Bill Murray and John Candy and everybody, but I also realized, this is gonna sound really weird, I felt like I had to explain a lot of the jokes to them. You know what I mean? And I felt like going, see, that's funny because like at 8 years old, I'm explaining to 10-year-olds going, but that's irony, you see, because he didn't know. So at a young age, I used to do a lot of impressions. I'm getting everybody pregnant.
That's a great choice of
mine. I miss my daughter. I'm getting everybody pregnant. Yeah.
How did I get started in doing comedy? I actually grew up in an Indian village in northern Canada, and I wanted to do comedy always as a kid, and I just went to an open mic in Vancouver, British Columbia at a place called The Punchline, which no longer exists, and I just did an open mic and did it. I got really drunk and went on. My show's always been a conversation, and it seems to become more of a conversation than a speech, if that makes sense. This year I had to do an hour. Last year I just snuck in under the wing of John Lovitz, and people actually showed up to see me, and I was thrilled. I was like, "What, really?" So, and I had a great time with him. I like it out here. It's a little different out here, and that's awesome.
I actually probably got started in like fifth grade. Well, in theater. You know, I started doing theater, and I did theater for a while, then moved to New York. I just started doing comedy probably 23 or 4 years old, instead of waiting tables. It's great. Tommy's great. Everybody, I tell you, it's a great crew, and it's really relaxed. Everything's very professional, but everyone's like, I said, hey, I don't have my shoes. Like, hey, no worries. You know, I don't have my guitar pick. Hey, that's cool. You know, but everything went off without a hitch, and it's great. This afternoon when I came to the rehearsal, I thought the theater was beautiful. And then sometimes you do a beautiful theater and the laughter and the applause doesn't come at you. But in this theater, it really shoots at you, and it's a nice feeling, you know, when they laugh.
Now, I'm Emil Marzullo. I'm the Economic Development Director of the city. And actually, the City Economic Development Agency is producing this show tonight for Showtime Entertainment Network. So we're here to have a good time.
So what do you think of this whole weekend for the city?
Well, it's great. I mean, everybody, you can hear in the auditorium now that people are just having a great time. Nothing but fun outdoors. We have, you know, the food trucks. And I learned something tonight that they make a little donut sundaes. I haven't had one yet. I did try a deep fried Oreo. And the comedy outside is very good. The bands are excellent. It's a great free entertainment venue outside. And everybody inside's having a great time, so I'm having fun.
I was a dancer, and I realized that dancing doesn't last too long, and stand-up comedians can go on as long as they can stand up. So I figured I was going to be able to stand up a lot longer than I was going to be able to kick. I was very flattered to be asked to do the comedy festival, and I heard great things about the theater, and absolutely they were right. It's a beautifully transformed theater, or restored, not transformed, restored theater. I was really looked at, you know, you look around and there's so many things that, oh my gosh, poor theater. It used to be so nice, and this theater was just gorgeous. I was so impressed with this crowd because it's not easy to keep your energy up. I mean, we do a few retakes here and there, and the more energy a crowd gives you, the better a comedian is. So I think they enabled us to be the best we could tonight.
Me and Bill met about 3 years ago. I was doing this show, Bill Bellamy's Who's Got Jokes, in Washington, D.C., we actually went over to Germany, got a chance to sit and talk to him. I was telling him what I thought, you know, how I looked at my career, and he, you know, he kind of looked at me and took a liking to me, brought me on a roll with him, and we started talking, you know, every now and then, and coming up with this concept about a great night out of comedy and fun for ladies, not just ladies, but it's called Ladies and Out, but of course men are welcome, but it's just spinned out from that little idea to what we have now as the Ladies Night Out Tour. It's been amazing. You think I'm a skater? I am not afraid of a camera. People are afraid of cameras. Look at me, people. Look at this face. This is like a face that's afraid of a camera. This face was made for cameras. I'm gonna duck down and come back up. Don't you move it. Did you miss me? I'm back. Shoot at me again. You think I'm afraid of a camera? I do this. Shoot it, people.
Well, the Ladies Night Out Tour is a concept show. We're saving relationships one joke at a time, you know what I'm saying? And we really wanted to do something that would really speak to the ladies, but also give the perspective of the male. You know what I mean? We're all in our relationships at different levels, and we just start writing jokes around that premise. And, you know, we started out as a concept and as an experiment in Houston, Texas, March 5th last year. It was a hit. We sold out every show. And then we started just going on the road with the guys and working on the jokes and writing at night and, you know, changing them up. And I think we got something that's really special. You haven't seen, first of all, you've never seen a comedian do a Ladies Night Out. So that's special in itself. And then the ladies seem to like all the guys, which is cool. And then the guys are cool enough that guys don't feel bad. So it works, you know what I mean? Everybody come to the party. San Bernardino got it going on, man. I had no idea that people were out here. I don't know where I'm at. I know it's hot and it's a lot of dirt. But the people are really nice, man. They came out tonight for the fun of it. And we want to thank the city and thank, you know, the theater is so beautiful. It's just get some more AC.
One thing that I would say to the city of San Bernardino is grow some trees. It's hot as hell out here.
San Bernardino, thank you very much for coming out to the Laugh Out Loud Comedy Festival. Was it a festival? Festival, I said it right.
San Bernardino, thank you. We love you. You took such amazing care of us. Thank you, San Bernardino.
San Bernardino, I love you. Now, if you just get an airport, everything would be better.
San Bernardino, thank you guys for supporting us. D-Lay, Bill Bellamy, Ali Sadiq, Jay Reed. It's an amazing show, people.
Hi, I'm Neil Patrick Harris, and you're watching Showtime. Oh, I see you, Clover. Clover making sure nobody got sticky fingers stealing his life. Everybody gonna get pregnant.